Hi y'all, Billy here. Welcome to the Messy Studio. I thought about maybe making another pen or, I don't know, doing some small project. And then I realized one must have one's priorities. And I've got one that I consider pretty, well, prioritizing. My wife got me some Patience and Nichols gouges for Christmas. And I bought this Jimmy Clewes quick release to go on them. The only problem is I don't have the handle. At first I had considered using this really pretty piece of rosewood. That'd make a pretty handle. But I hate wasting wood like this for shop stuff. Especially when I can cut this up into strips and make segmented bowls out of it. So I'm going to save this rosewood for that. So what I'm going to use is this oak flooring. Yeah, just a piece of oak flooring. I'm going to mill it up. I'm going to glue it up. And we're going to make this. No, it's not finished. That part's going to be a surprise. So stay with me and see how I do it. I gotta tell you, I really like these safety glasses that wrap around better than the ones with the shield, mainly because of the foam. They're prescription safety glasses, trifocals, actual safety glasses, got them from my optometrist, and I like them. However, and that foam seals the stuff from getting in your eyes. Just like my motorcycle glasses do. However, in the shop, if it gets a little steamy, they fog up. Anyway, so I got it. I got the stock milled. I just cut the tongues and grooves off the sides. You saw that. Thinned it down on the table saw to get rid of the ridges on the bottom. And as it turns out, and then ran it through my drum sander enough on the cut side, with the cut side up, just to smooth it up so I get a good smooth glue joint. Turn it over, knock the finish off. And as it turns out, it's just nearly exactly 2 inches square. Not quite, but real close. So now it's time to glue them up. And I noticed when I got to looking at it, it's nearly quarter sawn, at least on one end. And that's why you get this fleck, this quarter sawn fleck. So what I'm gonna do is glue it up in this orientation with quarter sawn fleck on this side and this side, and quarter sawn fleck in the middle over here. I don't know how much of that quarter sawn fleck is gonna show up in the end when I get it turned, but it doesn't matter because I have something special in mind for this anyway. So, we'll glue it up, clamp it up, and then come back after it's cured good to trim it and turn it.
Now I'm using Gorilla Wood Glue on this. I usually use tight bond, 1, 2, or 3, just depending on what I'm doing. I prefer tight bond, I've not tried this before. But I was in short supply and at Walmart, didn't feel like making a run by Lowe's. So, I'm gonna try it and see how it works. Put a good smattering on there. I keep all my bottles upside down, so the glue is handy. Lights is fogged up, can't see what I'm doing. I was looking for a spreader. The inside is what I'm worried about most. Most of the outside is going to turn away anyway. That's got enough glue for both of those. I know, they say you should wet both surfaces. But how many times do we do what they say? Make sure I've got my, yep. Got my quarter sawn, quarter sawn. I grabbed almost enough clamps. Okay. First things first. I want to keep these in semi-square orientation. And I prefer clamps like this for that because they work well. Let's do this the other way so I can center it around. I find that with most of these quick clamps, if you need serious gluing pressure, you're not going to get it. But it's good for alignment. What you do need for serious gluing pressure are clamps like this. Now, the only problem these clamps have are these tiny handles. I hate them. But I saw a fix for these from John Hines the other day, and I'm going to use them. As soon as I get my tool handle made, that'll be another of my priorities. Like I said at the beginning, one must know one's priorities. Right now, my priority is that tool handle. But that's just not quite big enough around, so I'm going to make these a little bit bigger. Keeping scrap wood laying around, even though my wife doesn't understand it, is good for something. Really. Yeah, I'm getting plenty of squeeze out, so I'm not worried about there not being enough glue in this joint. These are Harbor Freight specials. I don't like these so much. Believe it or not, I got these at Big Lots. I like the ratchet. They're smooth here so it doesn't bite as bad. The handles are a little bit bigger, but they're still not big enough.
I think that's enough excitement for one day. Let these glue up overnight. come back tomorrow, trim the ends. It's going to be, final product's going to be about 14 inches long. Right now I'm sitting at 16. So we'll be back. Okay, I've got it out of the clamps. Now I'm going to clean these edges up a little bit. They would probably turn off, but just make me easier to square it up on the table saw.
While I was editing this, I realized that my camera placement is just horrible. It was okay for turning pins, but anything longer than pins, like these spindles that I'm using for tool handles, you only get part of the shot. Partly because I'm constantly in the way of one camera, and the other one, I thought I was mounting in a good position, and turns out not to be so. So I have corrected that for future videos. I'll apologize now. Just bear with me through this one and we won't have this anymore.
about y'all, but I like it. You ain't seen nothing yet. About a half hour to dry a little more thoroughly. It's fairly dry now, and I'll come back and show you what I was planting. Okay, it's dry. Jimmy Clewes, who had Doug Thompson make these for him, made a tool handle. He burned it. It wasn't laminated like mine. I saw him do this and use gilding cream. So I wanted to try something. I don't have any gilding cream, but this was on clearance. General Finishes White Mist oil-based wood stain. It was on clearance at Woodcraft when I went in there a month or so ago. Done one thing once before, and it'll highlight this grain. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Let that set a few minutes and then wipe it off. Is just exactly the effect I was looking for. You get you in there so you can see that. you look at that? Isn't that gorgeous? All that grain popping. Sits until she dries. The only negative thing about those general finishes stains is the can says it takes 24 hours to dry. So I'm gonna let this set until tomorrow. I'm starting to hurt a little bit anyway, so Doc said when I start feeling the pain, it's time to call it a day, at least for a few hours. So this won't be dry enough to put a finish on until tomorrow. Dang it, I was hoping to get this handle finished today. But, oh well. I like the way it's gonna look. I'll come back and I think I'm just gonna spray it with lacquer. So, what I'm gonna do is tomorrow I'll come back, sand this nubbin off of the back, stand it up, shoot it with lacquer. Probably spray, I can put lacquer on every 30 minutes. I'll probably put 6 coats on it. And then I'll let it sit for a few days. But I'll put it together after about 24 hours. I just won't use it for 3 or 4 days. So I'll see y'all tomorrow. Last coat. So, I'll give this a few hours. I'm not going to buff this. It's a shop tool. If it was something I was going to sell, I would let it cure for over a week and buff it out. But I'm not going to sell it. I'm going to use it. I'm going to have to spray a little lacquer down here on the end. And I'll do that in an hour or so. Or another 30 minutes. I didn't show it. but I dipped the bottom of this where it didn't get sprayed in lacquer, and I'm just hanging it here. That should be enough. I don't need to give it any more coats than that. That one dip should take care of it. I've let it sit here so that it'll dry, and if there's any buildup, it'll continue to drain off the bottom. But I let it drain pretty good, so I don't think that's going to happen. So in a few hours, this will be ready to put together. It's already dry up here from my last coat. Looks good. I like it. So we'll let this cure, or not cure, we'll let this dry for a few hours, and then I'll epoxy the parts in. Okay, let's mix up some epoxy and glue this thing in. Oh, you couldn't see that. I had it out of picture. Alright, so put this piece on. Pull you back a little bit. Wipe off any excess. That'll make it nasty. We don't need any excess epoxy running out of the man. That is a pretty handle. Now let's go over to lathe and glue this in. Let me get some epoxy in this hole. Make sure it's thin, because I had to sand this hole to make it fit. This stuff is tight. All right, I'm going to start this in, and I'm going to finish pushing it with this. And there it is. We'll let this sit up. Well, here it is, the finished tool handle. All in all, I'm pretty happy with it. That white stain had the effect I wanted. I've got one of my Patience and Nichols gouges in it, half inch bowl gouge. I gotta sharpen it, but this one fits it. Three-eighths bowl gouge fits it. Three-eighths spindle gouge fits it. Who can ask for anything more? Oh, by the way, this quick release, this Jimmy Clewes quick release, these are made by Thompson. You can get them from my buddy Todd Raine. I'll have a link in the description below. He also sells these adapters in different sizes. I believe there's two sizes of this quick release as well. I wanted the bigger so I can use anything up to 3/4 of an inch if I want to. Or no, Maybe it's 5/8. But still, I think it's 5/8. But I like it. I'm happy. Well, I appreciate you watching. Please like and subscribe. That'll really help us out. Come back and see us. I'm going to do another tool handle. Maybe two. Then I got some other stuff I need to take care of. But, you know, like I said at the beginning, priorities. I needed to get these tools running. Got to have good quality tools. Or at least check out the difference between good quality tools and the stuff I've been using for 12 years. Y'all come back.